Hello there, I hope you're having a great day. Today I would like to take you through another experiment, well, several experiments I started doing. And this is my attempt to make gesso modeling paste, and even later on I tried on making the sand modeling paste, which I was not very happy, so I'll have to repeat this experiment in the future to perfect it. Anyway, for the first experiment, making gesso, I decided to use the plaster of Paris, or as it says on the pack, is fine casting powder, which the seller sent to me as I purchased it from eBay. So what I decided to use was, to start with, using a quarter of a cup of plaster, then a half of acrylic paint, and a quarter of glue. Well, basically what I would recommend, always leave the acrylic paint in the end. What I concluded based on my experiment and the components which we have here in the UK is to use everything in equal measures. Why? Because I didn't want the gesso to be very diluted. And you'll see later on I'm running the experiment. Well, using a previous recipe with the acrylic paint being half as opposed to the plaster and the glue being in quarter didn't give the right concentration. So yeah, that is why I'm recommended to use everything in equal measure and always add the acrylic paint at the end to ensure that you will make it as concentrated or diluted as you want. Later on, I continue doing an experiment where I made gesso using baby powder. So my mistake was to put first the acrylic paint and afterwards the glue, and in the end only adding the baby powder. Because of this mistake, well, what happened, I had to put like lots of baby powder in the end until I ran out. So that is why now I'm finishing this project here using the baby powder to see the difference. So always use all this, the glue, the acrylic paint, and whether you use the plaster of Paris or the baby powder, always use them in equal measures. Right, well, that was the experiment on the gesso. Next, I will be moving on making the modeling paste, and I'll be using the plaster of Paris. Now, one thing that is you have to know, well, basically when I watched these recipes of people making it in the States, they did not say that the plaster of Paris hardens straight away in like 5 or 10 minutes. So that was my mistake. I would not recommend to use plaster of Paris if you want your gesso or modeling paste to last for, say, months, 6 months or 1 year. For that, you'll have to use the baby powder. So in order to make the modeling paste, you'll have to use 1 cup of plaster, half cup of gesso, which, say, if you use plaster of Paris, you'll be using gesso made from plaster of Paris, and a quarter of the cup of glue. Again, always leave the glue for the end because you will have to decide how thick or thin you want it. If you already put the plaster of Paris, I mean, it's there. You might want to put water. Some people use water. Myself, I prefer to use more or less glue according to how thick I want it. But always remember this, using plaster of Paris or this fine casting powder, as it says on the packaging there, it hardens straight away, so it's going to last only 10 minutes, after which it's going to be very hard. So that is why you see me afterwards trying my modeling paste, which I made using the plaster of Paris. And yeah, it solidifies very nice, as you can see there. I'm using this stencil, and I'm very happy with the way it solidifies. So it's a very good experiment. Right, well, next I continue making my gesso using the baby powder, and I continue making my modeling sand paste, which I was not happy, so I'll have to work on it. Well, I hope that all this information helped you. Always think of what I said about the plaster of Paris when using it. And with this in mind, I hope that your projects will be helped by what I have done here today. So have a very good day, and thank you for watching. Bye.